Hello, today we shall see the spinning triangle, the concept of spinning triangle, and how this concept is used in compact spinning to improve the properties of the yarn. So let us understand the spinning triangle. The twist is generated at the traveler and the twist flows upwards towards the front roller nib against the direction of the yarn movement. We know that once the traveler rotates with say one rotation, so one twist is inserted, and that twist, as you keep on twisting the yarn, it will start flowing towards the front roller nib. And this flow of twist is against the direction of the movement of the yarn. That means the yarn is moving downwards, whereas the twist flow is upwards. So now here what we see is the side view of the rollers. And we are seeing two cases where there one shows a short spinning triangle and the other one shows a long spinning triangle. And if you look at the side view of this, we can see that this particular the fiber strand that is coming out of the front roller nib is making a wrap around the rollers. So from the side it will look like this, whereas from the front one can make out. Now this side view is for the short spinning triangle, because it ends over here, and from here onwards it leaves the surface of the bottom roller and is going towards the lappet. So with this we see that the twist should reach the front roller nib, but it never reaches the nib, since the fibers are wrapped on the rollers up to a point, after which the fiber leaves the roller surface as seen in the figure. Therefore, there is a triangle fiber bundle without twist called as the spinning triangle. So this triangle that we see over here is known as a spinning triangle. This region is the weakest and leads to a large number of end breaks. Since the yarn tension in the balloon is transmitted to this region without obstruction, while the twist unable to flow into the region of the spinning triangle. So one can see that without obstruction, the tensions in the balloon, that whatever is generated over there, gets easily transmitted right up to the spinning triangle. But at the same time, the twist, whatever is generated at the traveler, is not able to flow right up to the nip of the front roller. And because of this, the spinning triangle, this region that we are seeing here, remains weak. And they are liable, this because of this region, lot of end breakages may result. So twist here is zero, and therefore it is the weakest region. So now let us see the relation between the length and width of the spinning triangle. So whenever we say there is a spinning triangle, it has got both a length as well as width. So let us see the relation between them and how it affects the yarn properties. The drafting system on the conventional ring frame delivers the fibers over a width W. So the conventional ring frame, when we look at it, it is, or the drafting system on the conventional ring frame, there is a strand of fibers which is flowing along a certain width, say W, and as soon as it comes out of the nib, that is from the side view, if you see here, this is the nib area. When it comes out of the nib here, the width has been reduced, and this particular twist is not able to incorporate the edge fibers over here. The edge fibers escape the twist and they are just moving in their on their own path. So this is the region or the line which shows us the area just before the front roller nib, where we can see that the width is W. Now this width W is larger than the width WS of the spinning triangle. So this is the width S, WS of the spinning triangle over here. And this WS is always going to be smaller than this W over here, which is the fiber strand width. Some of the edge fibers are lost or are attached randomly to the twisted yarn core, leading to lower yarn strength and a higher level of hairiness. Because of this higher width as compared to the spinning triangle width, what we see is some fibers escape the twist, or they are loosely held into the core, and because of that one may get a lower yarn strength, because the fibers are not contributing towards the yarn strength. They are out of the body of the yarn, and also it leads to higher level of hairiness. The width of the spinning triangle is determined by the length of the spinning triangle. So this width is determined by the length of the spinning triangle. So one must look at how to control or what are the factors that affect this length of the spinning triangle so that one can go towards controlling the width of the spinning triangle. So with this statement here, we shall look at how this length is affected by various other factors. So let us see the relation between fiber disposition angle and the tie-in angle over here. So again the same diagram where we have this fiber strand flow width which is W and spinning triangle width as WS, and what we see here is the fiber strand is coming out and is getting twisted, and the twisting is at a certain angle over here, and whatever the fibers make an angle is marked as K over here. And as this particular fibers are coming out of the front roller nib, whatever angle the edge fibers are making, that is say nu, or rather nu 2, which is marked over here. If the twist level in the yarn is increased, the fiber disposition angle, rather K1 or K2, whatever is shown over here, is increased, and consequently the tie-in angle, that is nu 2 shown over here at the tie-in point E, that is at this point, also increases. So one can imagine as we go on increasing the twist, this angle will also increase. So when we look at this particular diagram over here with this statement, we have increased the twist and this angle K1 is more than as compared to K2. And again, when we see here N1 and N2, N2 is lesser than or rather N1 is more than N2 over here. And we can see that this angle has also increased. So twist always rises to a point where both these angles are equal. So one can see over here also one more difference. As we go on increasing the twist is able to flow more closer to the front roller nib. And always one must remember that the twist always rises to a point where both these angles are going to be equal. So as soon as you increase the twist level in the yarns, this angle has increased. So this this tie-in angle has increased, and because of this the twist is able to rise further beyond this point and further closer to the front roller nib. So this is the rise in twist at lower twist levels, that is this up to, twist can reach up to this level, and the moment we increase the twist is able to reach to this point, and that means there is an increase in the twist level. Therefore, it is observed that an increase in the above angles leads to a decrease in the length of the spinning triangle length, that is L1. So we can see that L2 was more and the length of the spinning triangle has reduced. So one can conclude from this particular slide these two statements. Low twist level means long spinning triangles, that is the first case. And high twist levels means short spinning triangles, that is the second case of it. So now let us look at the relation between wrapping angle and the length of the spinning triangle. So other than the twist levels which affect the length of the spinning triangle, as just explained above, the wrapping angle lambda of the fiber strand at the front roller also affects the length of the spinning triangle. So if you look at the rollers from a different angle, that is the side, one can see that this angle that this is making, the fibers that are making a wrap around the bottom roller over here, and after which the fiber strand releases or leaves the roller surface. If we were to take this angle over here, that is termed as lambda in this case. So the larger the wrap, so if this wrap were to be larger, or the fibers were to still touch further and then come up to here and then leave the roller surface, then in that case this angle lambda would have been larger. It would be something like this, and therefore longer is the spinning triangle length. So this wrap angle will also decide what would be the length of this spinning triangle. So therefore the front roller overlap reduces. So in our previous lecture we have seen the front roller is given a slight overlap, that means it is just shifted or tilted towards the front side of the drafting system. So that would reduce the length of the spinning triangle and also provide extra fiber guidance without clamping them. Also, the abrupt bending of the edge fibers is avoided the moment we give a front roller overlap. So with this, let us see the effect of long versus short spinning triangle on the various yarn parameters or the yarn properties. A long spinning triangle means a larger weak spot. We know that the moment the spinning triangle has increased in length as or width, then in that case it will show us a weak spot over there, because twist is not able to reach in that region, and therefore it will lead to a higher ends down rate and hairiness, because hairiness will always depend on the area of the spinning triangle. So similarly, a short spinning triangle will also result in higher ends down rate due to the following reason. So one might think that a short spinning triangle would lead to lower ends down, but that is not the case. A short spinning triangle also results in high ends down rate, and although the weak area, the area has been reduced in case of a short spinning triangle, still there is a different reason for the higher ends down rate here. So let us look at the reason. Assuming that the fiber being processed is longer than the length of the spinning triangle, we are first assumption that we are making is the fiber length is longer than the spinning triangle. So let us consider the following two cases, that is the two cases of the long spinning triangle and a short spinning triangle. In case of a long spinning triangle, the edge fiber F, so now in this diagram we can see the long spinning triangle is shown here, whereas a short one is shown here, and the edge fiber F that is there, it has to bend by a certain angle to when it is twisted. And this angle, suppose if it is termed as phi over here and marked like over here like this. Now, in case of a long spinning triangle, one can observe that this angle is lesser than that in case of a short spinning triangle. Clearly, it is seen that this angle is more over here. So just to emphasize what that the angle is more in case of a short spinning triangle, one can see these parallel lines drawn over here, and easily one can make out that this angle is more than this angle. So the yarn tensions are passed on mainly to the edge fibers. Here below, whatever is happening, that means twisting is happening, the twist will flow right up to this region, but at the same time, the tensions that are developed in the balloon, all those tensions are also passed on directly towards the spinning triangle, and they are able to reach right up to the front roller nib, the tensions, but at the same time one can say that the twist is not able to reach. So this is a situation where the tensions would be high in this region, and twist will not be sufficient to strengthen it and stop it from breakages. So the yarn tensions are passed on mainly to the edge fibers. So whatever tensions are developed, they are developed in the edge fibers first, and higher the angle phi, that means in this case where it is a shorter spinning triangle, in this case since the angle is higher is the fiber elongation. One can see the moment the angle increases, a lot of one can imagine this fiber will undergo more tension as compared to the fiber here in a longer triangle. So in that case, the fiber will undergo a larger elongation and therefore higher tensions. So therefore, the fibers in case of a short spinning triangle will undergo more elongation and are more liable to break as compared to a longer spinning triangle. So because of this particular reason, this angle that the edge fibers make, one will see a larger amount of ends down, similar to the case where ends down is higher in case of a long spinning triangle. So we are in a fix now whether to go for a long spinning triangle or a short spinning triangle, because both will lead to ends down due to different reasons, although, but ends down rate will be high in both the cases. So to summarize the above discussion, a long as well as a shorter spinning triangle, due to different reasons, although the reasons are different, both will lead to yarn hairiness, fly accumulation, reduction in strength and a higher ends down rate. So therefore, in order to improve the yarn quality, there has to be a significant reduction in the length as well as the width of the spinning triangle. A reduction in the width will reduce the angle phi, that is we have just seen in the earlier slide. The angle that the edge fibers make will be able to reduce the moment we reduce the length, and consequently the reducing the edge fiber elongation, resulting in lower ends down rate. So also the width of the fiber flow W discussed earlier in our few earlier slides must be exactly equal to the width of the spinning triangle. So if we are able to fulfill these conditions, that means the triangle length as well as the width has to reduce, and also the fiber flow W has to match exactly to the width of the spinning triangle. If these two conditions are fulfilled, in that case we can solve the problems of excessive yarn hairiness, ends, higher ends down rate, fly accumulation, and the reduction in yarn strength. So all these issues are addressed by the compact spinning system. Shortly in this we will try to understand how this is achieved over here. So in compact spinning, what is done is the fiber flow is laterally condensed between the drafting unit and the yarn forming point. So this is the yarn forming point and this is the drafting unit. Between this to this region, what is happening is we are applying a lateral condensation, because of which one can see that there is a reduction in the spinning triangle at the yarn forming point. So this is the condensing zone between the drafting zone and the yarn forming point over here, wherever this angle is triangle is being formed. The condensation is done by using aerodynamic forces. The fiber flow reaching the spinning triangle is very narrow, and the spinning triangle is almost absent. So one can see here the spinning triangle is very, very small, and it is almost next to not being there, or it's rather absent. And therefore, all the fibers are integrated into the yarn structure without any elongation in the edge fibers. So the problem of having this elongation in the edge fibers is almost not there anymore. So how does this COMFOR work? So a 3/3 drafting system with double apron is followed immediately by the fiber compacting zone 3. The fibers are supported and transported by the perforated drum. So there is a perforated drum over here, between which between these two top rollers over here the condensation is happening in this region. So one can see that the fiber, as we saw in the earlier slide here, the width has been reduced drastically in this region because of the condensation happening. So in this case also, this is a side view where one can see that the drum with perforations or rather a slot over here will help in the condensation of the width of the strand in this area before the formation of the yarn after this roller, after the fibers come out of this nip. A stationary insert with special shaped openings inside the drum. So inside this drum there will be a specially shaped insert, and which is stationary. It causes the airflow through the perforated drum, and the insert looks like this. This is the suction insert slot, and this insert is there inside this drum, which will help suction to happen in a particular decided area. The suction inside the drum condenses the fiber flow between the two top rollers. So as we have already mentioned, in this region the suction is applied. Condensation is completed before the formation of the yarn, that is which takes place after the second top roller. After the second top roller, here the yarn formation is taking place. So before that, condensation will help in reducing the spinning triangle so that we are able to improve the yarn properties. So what kind of improvements one can see in the yarn properties? Conventional, one can see the image, and the compact yarn gives a neater look. It has got a lower hairiness, higher strength and elongation, less fiber fly, significant advantages in downstream processing. So we'll look at some of these advantages one by one. Also, one can see that there is a the variation in the strength and elongation. That means the CV percentage is also reduced to a very large extent. So let us look at yarn hairiness and abrasion resistance. The condensation reduces whatever compacting they are applying in the drum region, perforated drum region, it reduces the yarn hairiness, especially the hairs longer than the than 2 mm. So from this graph that is shown here, one can see that this is the ring yarn which had got a lot of hairiness of 1 mm length fibers, hairs. And it has drastically reduced in case of a COMFOR 4, which is a compact spun yarn. Then one can see that in case of 2 mm hair length, again there is a drastic reduction. In case of 3 mm also there is a reduction, whereas if we go further, 4 mm length hair is absent, as well as all the fiber lengths which would have otherwise appeared in the conventional ring yarn are no more there. So there is a good reduction in the yarn hairiness. Also, improvement in abrasion resistance is seen, which reduces the deterioration during yarn winding. So again, through this graph, one can observe that the compact yarn that is shown in green over here, it is showing a lot, the abrasion is lower than as compared to the ring yarn. So this is, results are for 100% cotton combed yarns. So in the downstream processes, let us see the advantages that are offered by the compact spun yarn. One can see that lower yarn hairiness and improved abrasion resistance all allows the use of lower degree of sizing by up to 50%, leading to economical as well as ecological benefits, because the sizing agents that one uses, we are letting out it into the as an effluent, and therefore it will lead reduction in this size usage would lead to ecological benefits along with economical benefits. So one can look at the stoppages to judge the sizing performance. So stops per 1 lakh picks, one can see that in case of a ring yarn, one cannot process if at all there is a reduction in size. So at 100, if you are taking as a standard, then in that case, ring yarns would give you stops of around maybe 5 stops around 1 lakh picks. Whereas with the same figures, that means the same degree of sizing, one can see that there is a drastic reduction in the stoppages that are there. And if one were to go for a reduction in size, on the other hand, a slight increase in the stoppages is observed, but still it is lower than that of the ring spun yarn. But if we were to reduce the size percentage or a degree of sizing still further, then one can easily see that there is an increase in the stoppages, but not dramatically. It is slightly more than the ring spun yarns. Also, in case of in the second case, what we can see is that the angle, the twist has been reduced, and even in this case also we find that the stoppages have reduced, if we have reduced the size, degree of sizing. But if we reduce further, then possibly one can see an increase in the stops. So with this, let us look at another property improvement, that is fiber fly and fabric quality. It also reduces production of fly in weaving and knitting, because we are reducing the yarn hairiness and there is an increase in the abrasion resistance. So production of fly would definitely reduce both in during weaving as well as knitting. There is a reduction in number of fabric defects as well because of this, and an increase in machine efficiencies. So fabric strength, abrasion resistance and pilling behavior, all of them one can see an improvement. So fiber fly percentage, again this graph shows us, which is used for a compact spun yarn in knitting, one can see lower fiber fly and fewer foreign fibers over here. So one can see that there is a drastic reduction again by -55% reduction is seen over here in case of fiber fly. So now let us look at the fabric strength. Again, when we compare a ring yarn with the compact spun yarns, one can see that there is an increase in the fabric strength. One can see over here, even with twist levels which are lower, one can still see some amount of increase in the fabric strength. So this is again for 100% cotton for a count of 40s. And these two figures are, or rather the graph is for gray fabric as well as this lighter blue is for a non-iron finished kind of a fabric. So let us see the effect of compact spun yarn on the appearance of the fabric. Fabrics exhibit better luster and a softer hand if we are going to use a compact spun yarn. With compact spinning, yarns with still lower twist may be produced for a softer hand. So if one wants to go for a still softer hand of the fabric, then one must go for compact spinning, which allows us to go for a lower twist levels and therefore increase in the softness of the fabric. So one can easily see the appearance if this has got a neater look. So compact spinning offered by various manufacturers. There are various manufacturers which offer compact spinning. So up till now, whatever results we had seen, it was for Comfort Spin or by Reeters. There are other companies that offer compact spinning with a different name. Elite by Susan, Compact 3 by Zinsser, Comfort Wool by Cognitex, All Fill System by Marzoli, or Toyota's compact spinning. So there are various manufacturers which market the compact spinning system by various names, and they slightly differ in their construction and working. So in case of Susan, that is Elite, one can see that instead of the drum, we have an perforated apron over here. A porous apron runs over the tube, and the tube is connected to a vacuum. This vacuum is applied to the traveling fibers through a slot, and this is how the Elite system works. But almost all of them work on the same principle, that there is a condensation happening before, or rather compacting is happening before the formation of the yarn, so as to reduce the width as well as the length of the spinning triangle, and also make the fiber strand width, which is coming into the region, exactly equal to the width of the spinning triangle, so that all the fibers that are there are incorporated into the body of the yarn, so as to reduce the hairiness and improve the abrasion resistance. And because of both these properties, we have seen that there is an improvement in the efficiencies of the downstream processes, as well as the quality aspects of the fabric. Maybe they are defects, or maybe in the appearance of the fabric, definitely one can see the improvement in the fabric quality. Also, one can go for lower twist levels so that one can improve the handle of the final fabric, because compact spinning allows us to incorporate more all the fibers into the body of the yarn. So therefore, one can see improvement in strength, and therefore one can allow going for a lower twist level. So with this, we come to the end of today's session. Thank you.